Sunday Morning on CBS. And here again is Charles Osgood.
That's Sara Bareilles singing her Grammy-nominated song, Brave. The lyrics she writes never hold anything back, and they've won her a devoted following. With Ben Tracy, we take note.
Her music and her voice sound so sweet.
So let me thank you for your time and try not to waste any more of mine. Get out of here fast.
But in many of her songs, what Sara Bareilles is actually doing is not so sweetly telling someone off.
I might not say it to your face, but I'm sure I'll go and put it in a song.
I think some people will find that surprising because you seem so nice.
You know, I swear like a sailor. I find great joy in sort of being a little bit sassy and crass and, I don't know, going against the grain a little bit. I find a lot of joy in that.
I'm trying to let you hear me as I am.
That rebellious streak led straight to Bareilles' breakthrough hit.
I'm not gonna write you a love song, 'cause you asked for it, 'cause you need one.
Her 2007 debut single, Love Song, was the singer-songwriter's response to her record label. It was pressuring her to write radio-friendly hits.
It was kind of a nasty song, but it was, you know, very tongue-in-cheek, which is so me to, like, be nasty in a passive-aggressive way.
You basically write this song, which is kind of a kiss-off to some record executives, and then it becomes the hit.
Yeah, it's really ironic. And then to get on me.
I'm not gonna write you a love song.
Love Song was no joke. It was the number one song of 2008 on Billboard's Adult Contemporary chart. And it earned Bareilles a Grammy nomination for Song of the Year.
Tell the world that it finally got it all right.
She's now back in the hunt for Grammy Gold with her new album, The Blessed Unrest. It snagged a coveted nomination for Album of the Year. That surprised many in the industry, including Sara Bareilles.
That felt like Kid at Christmas excited. And I was trying to text my family, and my hands were shaking, and it was just like this moment of sheer joy. It made me look back at the record itself, which was such a labor of love and a lot of pain as well. It was a really hard record to make, and it was the product of a tough year in my life.
Bareilles ended a long-term relationship with her boyfriend, parted ways with her band of 10 years, and moved from Los Angeles to New York.
I didn't feel like I was on fire in any aspect of just who I am and who I want to feel like I am in my soul.
And not to go all therapist on you, but did you figure out what was missing?
Oh no, I'm a mess still. Oh my God.
You can be amazing, you can turn a phrase into a weapon or a drug.
Her uncertainty about herself may seem at odds with her latest hit. She says Brave was inspired by seeing a gay friend struggle with coming out. But when nurses and cancer patients at a Minnesota hospital posted this video online, Brave became an all-purpose, face your fears anthem.
It just felt like I was watching the song take flight and take on a life of its own, and it was becoming something bigger than it had even been intended to be. And that's always, oh my gosh, what an amazing hope for something that you create.
It also created a bit of controversy. 3 months later, Katy Perry released her hit, Roar. She was accused of copying Bareilles' song.
I used to bite my tongue and hold my breath, scared to rock and be amazing, turn a phrase. So I said quietly,
I mean, I can't say that I think that they don't sound similar. I've known Katie a really long time and we're friends. And at the end of the day, it was really only really good for my song. So thank you, Katy Perry, for that.
Hey, can I get a medium Americano, please?
And a medium cappuccino as well. My treat.
Armed with morning coffee, Bareilles took us to one of her favorite spots, the canals of Venice in Los Angeles. She lived near here for 6 years, and Venice is where she's written much of her music.
It's just so charming and it's so different, and you wouldn't expect that this is sort of in the middle of LA.
Bareilles grew up in the Northern California city of Eureka. Her mom worked in a funeral home. Her dad was an insurance adjuster. Bareilles taught herself to play piano.
Say, can you see?
She sang at Dodger Stadium when she was 14 years old and admits to being addicted to musical theater.
I look like Betty Crocker and I look like Donna Reed.
It was like Phantom of the Opera sweatshirt, hair in braids, and singing at the top of my lungs.
Ooh,
and that, I know.
That's a good look.
It's a really good look. Add some pink jeans and like a weird hat. I know. So I've always been sort of a fashion icon. This is like old stomping grounds.
During college at UCLA, she played small shows all over Los Angeles. She was a regular at a Chinese restaurant called Genghis Cohen.
What's the smallest crowd you ever played to here?
Seven. I remember that.
Seven people?
Seven people came.
How many of them did you know?
I think all of them. I mean, like it was.
But then she met some guys in a band named Kara's Flowers. They eventually called themselves Maroon 5. Frontman Adam Levine and the band took Sarah Bareilles out on tour.
Those boys changed the trajectory of my life in a big way. And yeah, I'm forever grateful.
You can have Manhattan. I know it's for the best. I'll gather up the
Most of Bareilles' songs are deeply personal. She says she needs to write her own music in order to feel like she's being honest.
Most of the time, I find it's easiest to sort of write about my own experiences. I'm very narcissistic. I have a lot of important things to say and a lot of songs to write about it.
So you're very busy.
I'm really busy with my own brain.
Which is why she still doesn't have time to write just any love song, because someone needs it.
I mean what I say, and the songs that I write come from my heart.
Ahead.
What's your favorite Tootsie Roll product? Do you have?